我是没有谈到，所以这边谈的比较详细。So now let's get to the precepts. 那现在谈的，看我们的回到正题来。Put our palms together. 合掌。Homage to our founding teacher, Shakyamuni Buddha. Homage to our teacher, Shakyamuni Buddha. Homage to our teacher, Shakyamuni Buddha. Homage to the Shida Assembly of Buddhas and Bodhisattvas. Homage to the Shida Assembly of Buddhas and Bodhisattvas. Homage to the Shida Assembly of Buddhas and Bodhisattvas. 无上甚深微妙法，百千万劫难遭遇。我今见闻得受持，愿解如来真实义。Supreme and wondrous Dharma, subtle and profound, really is encountered even in billions of years. That now I see it, hear it, accept and uphold it, and I truly understand the Buddha's actual meaning. 我们上周已经把道解讨论完了，所以今天我也开始谈这个云解。So last week we finished discussion about the stealing, the second precept. Today we'll start with the sexual misconduct, the third precept. Again, the five precepts on the five precepts sutra. 那我才从五戒开始谈的话，还是讲这个五戒相经。Let's read the text. 那我们大家一起合掌来念经文。佛告诸比丘：优婆塞不应生欲想、欲觉，尚不应生行，何况起欲、会、痴，皆无根本，不净恶业。The Buddha told the bhikkhus that Upasaka should not have the thought of lust or arousal of lust. They should not have, let alone create fundamental impure karma due to desire, hatred, and delusion. 我们就讲说，这是佛陀告诉比丘，记得这个五戒相经是佛陀是对着比丘们在讲的。So this is a teaching by the Buddha to the bhikkhus. If you to remember this particular sutra, the Buddha didn't expand it to lay people, he expanded to bhikkhus instead. Okay? That's why he said he taught the bhikkhus. So you both said, 这个男居士不应该生欲想，应该有欲念。这个当然指着那个色欲方面，欲觉，尚不应生心，你不应该想，不应该这样的有这种想法，何况起欲会痴，这个会我们一般讲的三毒就是贪嗔痴，痴是一样的，贪呢这个就从前是翻作欲，会就是嗔，所以就是应该起。三毒皆乎根本不净恶业，这根本不净恶业就是造了不净的恶业，就是因为贪嗔痴的关系造了根本，这是根本罪，重罪的意思。这个标点大概有问题，不应该是顿号。So the Buddha said that the upasakas, the male, the person, the man, should not have the thought of lust or the arousal of thought, the lust. Should not have the thought that they don't create fundamental, impure bhikkhama due to desire, hatred, and delusion. These are the three poisons. Okay. So you are not supposed to.Have the lustful thought, and let alone create this bad karma. Okay. Shi Zhong Huan Xie Yin Yu Si Chu. 男女黄门二根，女者人女非人女畜生女，男者人男非人男畜生男，黄门二根一同于上类。There are four kinds of beings with whom one might commit sexual misconduct: males, females, eunuch, and hermaphrodites. Females include female humans, non-humans, and animals. Males include male humans, non-humans, and animals. The same applies to eunuchs and hermaphrodites. 这个讲的就是说，犯邪淫有四处，这个处并不是地方的意思，而是四个对，有四种对象。男人、女人、黄门，这就是一般我们讲的太监，被男人被阉割阉了以后，黄门。二根指的一个人有男女性的，男根女根这个身上。So there are four kinds of beings that one might commit sexual misconduct: some males, females.Eunuchs are castrated male. Hermaphrodites are those people who has both male and female organs in their body. Okay. 然后呢，这个讲的女呢，指的是什么？等于是说雌性的，这包括女人呢，非人的女，就是雌的非人。畜生女就是雌性的畜生动物，雌性的。那非人的话，就是六道轮回里头除了人和畜生以外的几道，就是指的非人，包括天、阿修罗、恶鬼、畜生，那恶鬼、地狱，这就是非人。所以这个包括六道的众生。So females.Include female humans, non-humans, and animals. Okay. And males the same, male humans, non-humans, and animals. And then eunuchs and hermaphrodites, 同于上类, I think you'll be also included.Okay, 但是黄门应该 OK， 它指的就是可以是人里头的黄门，畜生里头有黄门，被阉割的畜生就很多。So this is talking eunuchs. This can be include human and animals.And for non-human, it's, I don't know, how do you do that? 那这个对于非人的话，像天人啊、天啊、恶鬼、地狱，这个怎么去阉割？这个很难说。二根的话，这也是一样，动物、人都可能有二根的情形。那非人是不是也可以二根？And for hermaphrodites, this also can happen in humans and animals. Whether this can happen in non-human, I'm not sure. Continue. 若有不善与人女、非人女、畜生女三处行邪淫，犯不可为。若人男、非人男、畜生男、黄门、二根、二处行淫，万不可为。And Vasaka who engage in sexual misconduct involving any one of the three places of a female human, non-human, or animal commits an offense that cannot be repented. If the act involves either one of the two places of a male human, male,non-human, male, animal, eunuch, or hermaphrodite. It's also an offense that cannot be repented. 这个地方就讲说, 如果一个男众, 和慈性的, 本身人也好, 非人也好, 畜生, 就是慈性的畜生, 三畜行邪淫, 犯不可为。 这里没有讲到三处是哪三处, 三处后面有讲到, 这个文字上有点前后到了。三处就是指的一般我们讲的口道、嘴巴，然后肛门也算，那阴道肛门算，就女性们有的阴道、那肛门。 还有口, so that's talking about a layman and engaging sexual misconduct involving three places of a female being. It can be human, it can be non-human, it can be animal. And these three places here is talking about mouth, anus, and vagina, okay, for the female. 那如果是对方是男性，就是你是个男人，跟着另一个男人行淫的话，那这个对方没有阴道，对不对？所以就是二处行淫，只有口道和肛门。嗯，if a man is having sex with another man, and of course, the man doesn't have vagina, so there's only two places, his mouth or anus. Okay? So that's what it's talking about. And eunuch is the same, because eunuch is a male, so they don't have vagina. 那这个黄门也是这样，等于像男人一样，黄门本来是男人，所以他没有阴道。 就是二根，二根他这个讲的也是二两处行淫，这我就不太清楚，他是不是二根的人是不是有阴道？这个。And for methodite, it's talking about two places. I'm not sure whether for methodite has vagina or not. Anyway, these are the places. 若发心欲行淫，为和合者，犯下可畏；若二身和合止，不淫犯中可畏。一般的话，Saga intends to engage in sexual misconduct prior to bodily contact is a minor offense that may be repented. If after bodily contact he stops performing sex, is an intermediate offense that may be repented. 就是你如果打算要和对方行淫，那你当然就是走到对方那里去了。但是两个人身体还没有碰在一起，那这时候呢，已经是犯戒，这个是下品的轻罪。 This is talking about the layman. Intends to have sex with someone, and of course he is a virtuous person. But before the bodily contact, it's already a minor offense, a light offense. Okay, it's a light offense, so it can be repented, may be repented. But once the body contact. And that's at least an intermediate offense, because if you stop performing sex, if you go on to have sex, then there will be a heavy offense. But if without performing sex, then once the body contact, then it's an intermediate offense. 那如果两个人身体碰在一起的话，那至少是中品的中品罪，可会。但如果更进一步， 行淫的话，那就是那很重的。 Continue. 若有何塞非是以配教有主，与忠诚协言者，万不可为。与侵犯如上说，一般 Vasaka engaged in sexual misconduct with his maid servant, who has already been engaged or married someone else. He commits an offense that cannot be repented. The less severe cases are earlier. 这个在古代家庭比较做的比较有钱的人的话，家里会有奴婢啊。这个讲的是家里头有这个奴婢，没事。但是这个奴婢呢，已经配嫁有主，已经是或者已经嫁给人了，或者已经等于是订婚的，已经有主了。那如果 你还跟这个奴婢这样的奴婢行邪淫的话，那他们就是不可讳了。嗯， in the old days when you are well off, you always in your family will have servants, and this is the case. You have a maid servant, and this maid servant has already been engaged or married someone else. And if this person commits, have sex with this maid, then it's a heavy offense. Okay? So this is nothing special. Here, talking about the three places and two places, 这里就讲到那个女性的三处，念一念，三处者口处、大便、小便处、出事三处、余处行。 As mentioned, the three places of a female are the mouth, anus, and vagina. Any sexual act involving parts of the body other than the three places is an offense that may be repented. 这个讲的女性的三处，中文讲的是小便处，这个就是我们一般现在讲的阴道，就是口。 肛门，还有这个阴道，那这三个地方如果是行淫的话，那是重罪；如果是在身体其他地方的话，那是重品罪，可悔。So then for the female, if involved with mouth, anus, and vagina, then it's a heavy offense. And other parts, if there's sexual act involving other parts of body, and then it's an intermediate offense that may be repented. <咳><咳>若有何塞卑使未配嫁，于中非道行淫者，犯可悔罪。 后身受报重重 Ibn Vasaka has sex involving another body part of his best servant, and she has not yet been engaged or married to anyone. He commits an offense that may be repented. However, he will experience heavy karmic retribution in his future life. 这个是和刚刚那个例子情形差不多的。这个奴婢呢，还没有嫁给人家，也没有订婚。然后这个居士呢和这个奴婢非道行淫，在不在刚刚讲的前面那个三道行淫的话，这个当然是可悔。Okay. 虽然只是可悔的，但是这边讲了后生受报罪重，以后呢来生所受的果报罪很重的。虽然这是可悔罪，那这个应该就是属于是等于是业道罪，业道罪很重。So this talking about the maid servant again, and this sex involving other parts of the body, then those three places we talk about it. besides this servant, this maid, is not being engaged or married to anyone. And this lay person will commit an offense. They may be repentant in the media offense. It's not heavy offense. However, he'll experience heavy karma and retribution in his future life. So even though in this life, the offense, the breaking precept, it's not that heavy, it's intermediate offense. However, the karma and retribution will be very heavy. And as in the future that he'll experience, he'll experience that retribution. And Masaka, who has sex involving two places of his male servant, commits an offense that cannot be repented. The less severe cases are as mentioned earlier. 这个讲到说男众和男的同仆使人就是他的家里的奴隶男的奴隶行淫的话那如果是在前面讲了两处就口处和肛门的话那就不可讳其他的情形和前面讲的是一样男众 So this is talking about a layman sex with the male servant, okay? And if it involves the two places, or the mouth or anus, then it's a heavy offense, okay? And other cases is same as before. 继续念,若人死乃至畜生死者,生根未坏,共以行邪淫,女者三处万不可为。 侵犯同上说, having sex with a dead human or animal whose body has not yet decayed and in which the egg involves the three places of this female corpse is an offense that cannot be repented. The severe cases are explained earlier.
这个讲的就是说, 一个人, 和死人呢，或者是死的畜生，行淫，那这个尸体呢，生根未坏，就是还没有腐烂，所以还看得出这个身体的各部分。所以如果对方是个女的，女尸的话，三处就指的前面讲的那三处行淫的话，那就是不可讳。所以。
这个，所以行淫戒的话，就即使是死人、死的畜生，都是犯众。 So this is talking about that if a dead man have sex with a dead human or even animal, dead human, and the corpse has not been decayed, so you can still tell the different organs, and if the egg involves a three place of this female corpse, as we explained before, then it's an offense, the heavy offense cannot be repented. Okay. So, so for this precept, even the dead animal, you have sex with a dead animal, can be heavy offense. This is very different from the killing precept and the stealing precept. <咳>在前面<咳>杀戒和盗戒<咳>要犯众的条件<咳>对方必须是人，对不对？必须是你杀的必须是人，然后偷的必须是人物人的东西，<咳>没有才是犯众。 但是这里的话，这个畜生都是犯众，也不光是活的畜生，也死的畜生都犯众。If you remember that for the killing precept,
to become to commit a heavy offense, the victim must be a human, okay? And for stealing precept also, the stuff it still must be belong to a human. So it's talking of human. But here, for this particular precept, even animals, you have sex with animal, that can be a heavy offense. Okay? Not even lab animals, and that animal can also be a heavy offense. So this is a very strict in terms of the heavy offense. 所以这个要犯众其实是比较容易的事情。 继续念，若优婆塞自受八支行淫者，犯不可畏，八支无复邪正，一切皆犯。 And the Pasaka who has taken the eight precepts but still engaged in sex commits an offense that cannot be repented. For eight precepts, there is no distinction between permissible and illicit sex. Any sexual act is an offense. 这边讲的这个八支就是我们一般讲的八关斋戒。 就是你一个人如果已经受了八关斋戒，那你在受这个持八关斋戒期间，如果还行淫的话，那就是犯众，当然就是有三处男女众三处男处二处，就是不可讳。那具体讲就是这个八关斋戒呢，无复邪正，就是邪淫和正淫呢，一切皆犯。 邪淫指的就是夫妻之外的关系，正淫是指夫妻之间的。那这个五戒里头，这个是邪淫戒，就是说夫妻之间可以有房事，没有问题，那个是个正淫。但是当你受了八关斋戒的时候，八关斋戒是不能够有行淫的，所以。 在这种情形下，就是犯了戒，而且是重罪。So this is talking about eight precepts. If you have taken the precepts during the period that you are upholding the precept, and if you still engage in sex, then that can be a heavy offense. Okay. And of course, it isn't involved with the right place, the place, the three places, and you female and two places, the male. And he said, a precept, there's no distinction between permissible and illicit sex. This is talking about that for the five precepts, talking about sexual misconduct means the relation outside the marriage, actual marital relation is called the sexual misconduct. And here is used illicit sex. This is the adultery sexual misconduct. And permissible is between married couple, cordial. And this, for eight precepts, you can even, between spouse, husband and wife, cannot have sex when you uphold the eight precepts. It's because the eight precepts does not permit any sexual act, just like eight precepts is a monastic precept. So it's not like five precepts. Five precepts only refrain from misconduct is outside the marriage and it's prohibited. But between married couples, it's permissible, it's okay. For eight precepts, it's totally different. So this is something that when you uphold the epistle, you have to be very careful. Let's continue. 若优婆塞虽都不受戒，犯佛弟子境界忍者，虽无犯戒之罪，然后不得受戒，乃至出家受具足戒。 Suppose that a lay person who has never received any precept offense and the Buddhist who upholds the precept of purity. Although the offender commits no offense of breaking the precepts, he will never be allowed to receive the five precepts and alone become a monastic and receive the complete precepts. 一个居士，难众，他虽没有受戒，没有受五戒，这是最基本的。那从这里可以看出来，这个优婆塞，就是只要打了皈依以后就可以了。嗯，这个没有受戒，他都这个经文里头都讲的优婆塞，不受戒，但是没有戒在身，但是你犯了侵犯了其他境界人。 就指的受了八关斋戒的人以上，包括出家人在内。那这样子的话，虽然你没有犯戒，对不对？因为你没有戒在身啊，但是呢，你以后呢，永远不能够受五戒，那更不要讲说出家了。嗯，So this is talking about a lay person who has never received any precepts. Chinese actually is upasaka. I think they should use upasaka. And upasaka would never receive any precept. So according to this text, that upasaka, any Buddhist can be called upasaka so long as they have taken the the refuges. Okay. Before taking the five precepts can be called upasaka. And was they never received any precept offense. A Buddhist would uphold precept purity. Precept purity means like at least like a precepts celibacy. Of course, including the monastic. Then even though this person doesn't have any offense of breaking precept, because he doesn't have any precept. However, he'll never be allowed to receive the five precept later, and let alone become a monk or nun. Okay. So this is to was to protect the Buddhists, who especially monastic, and the people who uphold the eight precept. 这个当然就是来保护这个出家人，还有保护那个持八关斋戒以上的人。那当然就是要非常小心，你这个虽然说你没有受戒，但是你如果侵犯了这些境界人的话，那你就等于就是被踢出来佛门外，你永远没有办法受戒。So You have to be very careful, even though you don't have precepts. But if you offend someone about the precept purity, then although you don't commit any offense of breaking precept, but you are not allowed to receive five precepts later. Right? 怎么样? 为什么这境界人不好受五戒人呢？受五戒的人，他没有那么严重啊，没有那么严重的，那主要是保护出家人。嗯。Let's continue. 佛告诸比丘：无有二身
生生界生，若善男子生起七宝塔，至于梵天，若能窥止其罪上有可，窥无界生，其罪无量，受谁如一罗龙王。
The Buddha told the bhikkhus, I have two bodies, the physical body and the precept body. Suppose a good man, for the sake of my physical body, builds a pagoda of seven valuables, then reaches the Brahma heaven. Anyone who damages this pagoda commits an offense that may be repented. However, anyone who harms my precept body commits immeasurable offenses and will undergo suffering as the dragon king Rampatra. <咳>这个地方佛陀就讲说，他有两个身体，一个是身身，就指的我们这个色身；另外一个戒身，就是戒律本身，有一个身是戒身。 那如果有个人呢，为了我这个，色身呢，起七宝塔，这七宝塔高到梵天天上去，如果有人来损害这个七宝塔的话，那个罪还可以还是可悔的，但是如果有人损害我的戒身的话，那个罪是无量。 受罪如一罗龙王，这是龙的故事，我们以后再讲。So here the Buddha said that he has two bodies, the physical body and the precept body. Now suppose a man, for the sake of the Buddha's physical body, build a pagoda of seven valuables, and so high reach the Brahma heaven. And another person damaged this pagoda and commits an offense that may be repented. Okay. So even though this pagoda is very valuable and very so tall, so high, and this offense can be repented. However, anyone who harms Buddha's precept body commits immeasurable offense and will undergo suffering and as the dragon king Rampatra. The story we can talk about it in the future. 那这个强调就是说你犯了亏损了佛的戒身的话，那个罪很重。 所以前面讲的这个，你犯的那个境界人，那个境界人他持戒，所以那你和这个人，犯了的话，侵犯的话，你就破了他的戒身，破了他的戒，就等于破了佛的戒身一样。所以那个罪很重，为什么不能再守五戒了？不能守任何戒？
So this is talking about the precept body, the monastic, especially the people who uphold the precept purity, they have this, in other words, they have the precept body of the Buddha. And if you violate those people, you are damaged, you are harming the Buddha's precept body. Because the other person's precept broken, so you break the precept body, and that's why it's, the offense is heavy, and you cannot come to take the precepts. Yeah. I think we'll stop the discussion here. Because I think maybe people still have questions about the stealing precepts. Last time we didn't finish answering the question. 那我们迎接就目前先谈到这里。 那剩下的时间我们来讨论，如果大家有问题的话，因为上次还有很多，有人有关于盗窃的问题，还没有那机会回答。现在如果大家要问问题的话，可以问，可以打在那个chat box里头，或者举手。 So you can type your question in the chat box. Or raise your hand, we can unmute you. Okay.
他是他本人是一个房东，他有房子出租给别人房客，那他到房客的房间厨房去呢，先就用了房客的纸来做清洁，然后呢才去征得了房客的许可。他就问这样是不是有犯这个菩萨戒或者是五戒中的盗窃？ Okay, so this is a landlord who went to the room of the tenant. He or she asked, if I need kitchen paper to do cleaning, out of convenience, for convenience sake, I use the tenant's kitchen towel, the paper towel, to wipe for cleaning. And then I asked the tenant's permission later. Did this break the precept against stealing in either the five precepts or the Bodhisattva precept?
You don't have permission, right? And you take the sub. That's breaking the precept already. Because what? We talk about once the thing, the stuff leave the place, then it's done deal. Although later you ask for permission, it's better than without asking anything. But it's an offense. But this is very light because the paper doesn't cost that much. It's a light offense. That's a good. 你在拿这个纸的时候，你没有得到这个主人的同意啊，所以这个已经是等于是犯戒。除非说你是想说对方会有的，你认为对方会同意。Unless you think the person, the tenant will agree with you, you are so close together, there's no problem. Try to avoid that in the future. This is not any big deal, but then you have to be careful. It's not your stuff, you have to get the permission first. 这个当然不是一个什么大问题，因为这个纸很便宜的，顶多是个轻罪，但是就是要很小心。 任何人东西，你必须要有对方允许，对不对？没有允许的话，你不要去动它，去动它的话，你就可能会犯贱的。OK。他的第二个问题还是这个房客的问题。你可不可以问其他人的问题？不要历史他，问题太多了。有其他人问题吗？
其他人和敏辉，深圳的，他想。
再问一下，不可悔是什么意思？各位，就是说你没有办法忏悔了，没有办法忏的。但是，就是我们北传里头，你要能够见到好像的话，是可以的。OK, I don't think we need to translate this one.
下一个问题是梁宁的范净提的，这是指这个今天讲的显应戒。他说：“师父，如果夫妻一方皈依了，另一方没有皈依，还可以生小孩吗？还算淫吗？”
这五戒没有证人可以啊，男女夫妻之间行房事没有问题的，所以是戒邪淫嘛，不是戒淫呢，不像八关斋戒，八关斋戒才是说不能够有任何的行房的事情，那这皈依也没有受戒啊，是不是？
皇的，这没有问题啊。他的下一个问题是指，如果有时候在嘴上就习惯夸谁漂亮，谁长得帅，这个是邪淫吗？<笑><笑>
这个跟邪淫没有直接关系的，你是称赞人家怎么样，这个。
没问题。下一个问题是。Okay,
just to clarify that the five precepts does not forbidden, does not forbid that the sex between husband and wife. Okay, it's totally okay. So it's freedom from sexual misconduct, it's actual marital relation, which this is forbidden.
吉林长春的杨振秀的问题，请问法师，在佛前自己发愿受五戒算是受戒了吗？你发愿受五戒，那个不算受戒，那不算受戒。你必须要出家人传给你戒，那才是要经过一定的三皈五戒的仪式。 那才是得到戒体才有戒。So this question here is that if I just take precepts in front of the Buddha statues and I make a vow to uphold these five precepts, does it count as that I have taken the precepts? No, this doesn't count. Okay, you need to go through the ceremony conducted by monastic. Otherwise, it doesn't come. OK, 还有呢?
下一个问题是北京的谢家丽，他说请问法师，我要买房子，已经交了定金，之后呢，在一个月时间里呢，发现卖主呢有欺骗的情况，事先没有告诉我，那我就要求他们把定金退给我，他们答应了，但是拖了一段时间才想给我，他说这个我不算道。
我不算犯盗戒吧？你没有偷什么东西啊？是不是？你是发现对方有欺骗的行为情况吗？就没有问题的，就是这样。就这个。
那回到那个正例文的第二个问题啊，第二个他的第二个问题是指房东跟房客，是房客呢，租房结束了，搬出去之后呢，留下了一些东西，并没有把想打算把那些东西再拿走，那这个时候如果房东使用这些东西，算不算犯盗戒？你就讲英文吗？啊
，so。
This is regarding landlord and the tenant. So I, as a landlord, I rent out a house to other people. Okay, after their contract is over, the tenant moved out, but the tenant left some items behind and did not have an intention to take those items back. So if as a landlord, I use these items, do I break the precepts against stealing?
这个东西，那个房客留下来的，表示他不要的东西啊，对不对？这是无主物的，没有主人的东西啊，当然可以用的，没有问题。
It's the tenant that to stop there. It means that he doesn't want it. He want it. Then the stuff belongs to no one. So there's no owner. The stuff, of course, it's okay to use it. Okay? 没有其他问题的呢?
哦，刚才最后又提了一个。 深圳罗建宏提的， 请问法师， 如果在梦里有性行为， 算不算犯戒？
梦里的都不算， 因为 if you have like a sexual activity in the dream, it doesn't count. Doesn't count. Maybe we can continue some of the, these factors. Okay, we can continue to talk about the conditions of the 那首先就是这个讲的邪淫戒，这个讲的婚外情，就是 so again, this is talking about sexual misconduct. This having sex outside marriage, okay, these are actual marital relationship. And there are three factors for heavy offense. 三元成犯不可为，就只有三个条件。 不像杀戒，不像盗戒， so there's only three factors, sense by three factors, then can be a heavy offense. The for killing is a five factors, right? Stealing is six factors, and this is only three factors. 那这个在杀戒里头，犯众是有五个条件，要两个五个条件都满足。 盗戒是六个条件都满足 okay, 所以这个比较容易犯很重。第一个条件是说是造，是说是对的地方。前面讲过了，就是男对方是男人的话，就是他的肛门还有口。 那对方是女的话，就是肛门、阴道和口道。 So the first one is those the places of entry, five. That's five, and that's for the female is three places, and male is two places, totally of five places. Okay. 那这里特别要讲的就是说，他这个 不光包括人在内，非人畜生都包括六道众生都包括在内，不是只有人。对，而且我们前面讲过，这个死者生根未坏也算满足这个条件，是满足。So this is including not only humans, also non-humans, animals, or even corpse. Okay. So this is very broad, including three. 那第二个条件，我们要有那个淫心呢， it's lustful thoughts. Okay, you have the thoughts. Yeah. 最后一个条件叫嗜睡。 Okay. 怎么样定义嗜睡？就是说，这个男根呢，进到前面讲的那五个地方，只要稍微碰到一下。 入壶马许，就是你的男根进到前面讲那五个地方，你的触啊，只要稍微的碰到，就像芝麻一样那么小，或像一个毛头那么小，对吧？那就算满足这个条件。So the last factor is the male organ enters any of the five orifices talking about earlier. Even with just the extent of sesame seed or tip of hair. Okay. So that means that they just touch a little bit, just lightly touch
these five places, then satisfy those factors. Okay. 这个和道界，我们讲说离本处，你只要轻轻的离开东西，你离开一点的话，那就算离本处。那这里也是很类似的，就是稍微碰到了，就算满足这个条件。Okay. If you still remember for the student precept, you need to just move the object from its place. So you just lightly move that a little bit, then it's done deal. It's similarly here, if the male organ just touch lightly to those five places, then it satisfies the spectrum. Okay. So these are the three factors for the heavy events. 那这个就是道界犯众的这个 三个条件。 Okay, I think we'll... Any other questions?
您先要回答吗？要回答怎么样？要回答。一个是深圳何敏辉又问提问，还是房东和房客问题。如果房子租给别人，房客呢在厨房做肉或者做别的任何不如法的事，
我虽然不犯戒，但是也是造业了，所以作为房东的话是这样。这个跟你没有那么直接的关系的，对不对？当然，你如果能够租给一个吃素的人，那当然是最好了。但是你怎么去找这个房客？难得找那房客，所以不用担心到这个
这么细的问题。下面还有一个，你要用英文吗？还是不行？那个不用英文的。深圳的范敏提问题，他说如果受朋友邀请住朋友家，稍住几天。朋友在家或者不在家的时候，使用朋友的任何饮食，甚至喝水，都需要事先请朋友同意才可以吗？否则会犯盗戒吗？
你在朋友家住，那朋友是不是允许你用这些东西？喝水当然是没有问题的，对不对？那饮食方面，你恐怕要问问清楚一点比较好。就是那你问清楚了就没有事了，不要没有问你就用的话。 到时候人家也许还不高兴呢，是不是？So this is talking about that when you stay in your friend's house, and when you are alone in his house, can you drink water or have any food from the refrigerator? I think that is. Water, of course, is no problem, right? And for other food, I think it's better that you ask the owner whether it's okay, then you can take them. Okay, so
有一个人举手，你要太晚了还是要回答？那么问的什么问题？那我就
ask. No, they say excellent touch the icon.
Okay.
那就没有了。他讲说，那我出去采花，那也不行吗？属于土地爷爷的采花，采什么采野花还是什么？你是采什么样的花？
他如果写属于土地爷，可能是指野花，对。<笑>野花。
那你就跟土地公讲了，<笑>没有那么严重啊，这个是无主的东西嘛，是。<笑> Okay. So let's see. So this coming Sunday, we are continue to have the forum. So this coming Sunday will be Nippon, and I don't have his topic. Is Dr. Ye online? Maybe Dr. Ye can say something about this coming Sunday. You unmute him? Ray, 你可不可以讲一下这礼拜天你碰要谈些什么？
啊，你碰现在在 in a 1 month 这个 retreat, so I am going to talk to him probably tomorrow,、
uh-huh.
and then I got to know what he's going to talk about.
Okay. Can you briefly introduce him to everyone?
Yes, Nippon is the founder of Service Space, which now have over 500,000 volunteers over the last, started about 15 years ago. So he has been doing great projects, primarily providing, he wants to change the society from a transaction-based society to a gift economy. So he has been doing phenomenal job in terms of multiple things, especially in this very uneven world during the pandemic, and propagating compassion out in every means. For example, he has a Karma Kitchen that where they rent a usually rent a kitchen on one day that the owner doesn't use it, and they don't charge anything, and the people can live whatever the amount or just leave. So this has been has been wonderful effect, especially for people at the lower class, poor people. Nippon 先生这个他十五年前他还很年轻的时候他就出来做志愿者，然后他这个他想把这个整个社会从一个交换的就是交易的这个形式变成一个送礼物的形式，就所有东西都是送出去而不要回收的。他们希望他送出去的东西可以经过其他人送给再送给别人更多。所以他这个在15年之中现在有50多万义工做各式各样的事情，有的是他有一个叫所谓 Karma Kitchen, Karma 这个饭店，他是普通来住别人的饭店，就是别人普通饭店可能有一天或者两天是关门的，他们就把他们租下来，然后别人来的话可以点菜，可是没有这个菜，没有这个价钱，就是说你吃完饭你就走了就可以，也可以，可是你愿意付给下一个人的话也可以。就是说在台湾的话，上次我跟他在台湾是吧，我们去跟一个咖啡店，这个就跟他说我们要捐几个咖啡，就把它钉在墙上。所以有的人他譬如说无家可归人，他想喝咖啡可能没有钱，他进来他就跟可以跟这个威士说 我要墙上钉一杯墙上那个咖啡，那墙上有人捐的咖啡，有也可能不同咖啡，他就可以拿一份下来就自己喝。所以他想把整个这个社会，变成一个互相给礼物的社会，而不是互相买卖的社会。所以他是非常非常一个很有感应力的这个演讲者。那么像德国有一个很大的这个报纸认为他是全世界最有能力的100个人之一，所以你们会很喜欢听他的东西。谢谢。
因为这边来讲讲英文。
哦，这边 OK。这个他是he's well, very well known now. Besides half a million volunteers, President Obama appointed him in the Council of Social Change many years ago. And Dalai Lama recognized him as an unsung hero of compassion. And German's OOM magazine named him top 100 most inspiring people in 2018. So, but he's very, very dynamic speaker. So you want to hear him.
Okay, looking forward to that talk. And do you want to introduce briefly about translator? This can just say that in Chinese will do.
Carol Xu, 是这个，他是 actually 是 service space 里面的 volunteer 之一。他这个有一个博士，是社会跟心理学的博士，这个他也常常做 meditate， 然后他也 meditation， 然后这个他有一个 circle 叫 mindfulness nurturing compassion leaders， 这个 circle 是中文的，所以他是非常非常在这个 service space 里面非常非常这个活跃。
是礼拜天的中文翻译的人。
中文翻译，对。
Okay, so very good. And we're looking forward to Nippon's talk. 那我们就回想了 ，Let's dedicate merit. Okay.